Environmental certificates bring money to the table for lots of businesses in the renewable energy and the energy efficiency sectors. And the fact that it can be such a large proportion of your income means it's a good idea to understand how these certificates work. NextGen brokers are involved in the trading of all sorts of commodities, from energy contracts to environmental certificates. I'm here today with Dan Foster, who's the CEO of NextGen. Hi Dan, thanks for coming down. Can you tell me a little bit about some of the environmental certificates that are traded in the market?
Pleasure to be here, thank you. There are four main types of certificates, two established under a national scheme and two under state-based schemes. We have STCs and LGCs, which are a nationwide scheme. STCs are small-scale technology certificates that are generated by solar hot water and solar panels on people's roofs. LGCs, large-scale technology generated by large-scale projects like hydroelectric and wind farms. And then there are state-based schemes in Victoria, which are called VEECs, Victorian Energy Efficiency Certificates. And in New South Wales, they're called ESCs, again, Energy Savings Certificates, generated by upgrades to buildings, LED lighting and all of that sort of improvements to the electricity supply.
So who are the buyers of these certificates?
Well, these certificates have to be surrendered by people who sell electricity. A certain proportion of the electricity they sell has to be covered by these certificates. So it's mainly electricity retailers and also generators who have standalone electricity contracts with some big customers like smelters and that kind of thing.
So who are the sellers of the certificates?
Well, the certificates are usually generated by small companies who then go to people like Demand Manager to aggregate them into a size large enough to be traded in the market.
We like using brokers to get the best price in the market, but are there other benefits for using a broker?
Well, the major one is transparency. Brokers act for both buyers and sellers. They don't have any skin in the game themselves, so they will always get you the best price on the day for your certificates as a buyer or a seller. There are other things as well. Obviously, we issue daily reports. Every time we do a trade, we send our customers a report that says we've traded X amount of certificates at this price. So even when you're not in the market every day, you're always kept abreast of all the prices as they happen every day. We also issue weekly reports on what's happened and the general feel of the market. And obviously, we're always talking to everybody in the market. So if there's any news out or if there's anything that's influenced the market one way or the other, we'll always be able to tell our clients, what we're seeing.
So what are the choices for selling environmental certificates?
Well, the majority of these certificates are traded in what we call the spot market, where if somebody's generated sufficient certificates, they have them on hand right now, they sell them at spot, so they deliver them in a few days and they get paid at the same time. You can also trade what we call forward markets, where if you know you've got a project that's going to mature in a couple of months' time and it's going to give you, X amount of certificates, and you want to lock in a price for them now, you can negotiate a price for delivery at some forward date. And then when you get the certificates, you've already locked in that price.
Obviously, having a forward contract means you need to be certain about your ability to deliver at those dates. But are there other more complicated financial instruments?
You could go one step further in complication and look at the options market, where you can take out what is effectively an insurance product. So if you're afraid the market may fall, you can pick a level where you don't want it to fall below and, for instance, buy a put option where you can buy the right to sell at that fixed price should the market fall below it.
Well, a big thank you for coming down and sharing your knowledge on this topic.